just wanna be where you are. And I just wanna be near your heart. There is nothing like your love. Jesus, there is nothing like your love.
Broken down and tired of living life on the merry-go-round, and you can't find a fighter, but I see it in you, so we gon' walk it out. Move mountains, we gon' walk it out and move mountains. And I'll rise like the day. I'll rise unafraid. I'll rise up, and I'll do it a thousand times again. And I'll rise up, I'll like the waves. I'll rise up, in spite of the ache. I'll rise up, and I'll do it a thousand.
This holy bond of marriage was instituted by God at the very beginning of history. A man shall leave his father and his mother and hold fast to his wife, and they shall become one flesh. What therefore God has joined together, let man not separate. Love is patient and kind. Love does not envy or boast. It is not arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice at wrongdoing, but rejoices with the truth. Love bears all things.
I promise to put your needs before my needs. Because I choose to love you, I promise to always find my greatest joy and pleasure in every single moment with you. Because I choose to love you, I promise to put you first when you're not easy to love. Because I choose to love you, I promise to be true to you when the stresses of life seem to overwhelm us.
Choosing to love someone is no easy task because love requires daily commitment. Because I choose to love you, I promise to be true to you when the stresses of life overwhelm us. Because I choose to love you, I promise to continually reflect in our relationship the self-sacrificial love that Jesus shows us. Because I choose to love you, I promise, and I promise to be your best friend. I, Danielle, choose you, Travis, to be my husband every day from this day forward.
The Lord bless you. The Lord give his grace to you. The Lord's face may it shine upon you, and the Lord's countenance may lighten you up and give you peace. In his name do I pray. Amen.
And now the moment you've all been waiting for. It's now my pleasure and privilege to introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. Travis and Danielle Alski.
These dry tears are steaming up my cheeks and turning them rosy red. I'm trying to smile it off. Turn my gears and lean against this speech I've tucked into my bed. It's hard to slide it off. And so I pull on my prettiest dress. You know I put on my Sunday best. I do it all for my dinner guests. I call my friends and you see right through me in the end. Won't you sit at my table?
You know, don't be like the foolish man who built his house on the sand, but be like the wise man who built his house on the rock, which is Jesus Christ. And as the old saying goes, we're not losing a daughter, we're gaining a son. And we love you, Travis. We love you, Danielle. And welcome to our family. We love you very much, Travis and Danielle.
There's nothing on earth better than love in each other. Embrace everything, embrace life, and live it to the fullest. You guys have a great start.
I want to say welcome to family, Danielle. We're so thrilled to have you. You are the perfect mate for him. You guys are perfect together, and I'm so happy for you.
Be silly, make each other laugh, and laugh at yourself, more importantly. Because when you look in the mirror, the funniest thing you'll see is what's staring back at you. I know I do. And thank God every day for the gift that he's provided, and God bless you both. Love you.
Danielle and now Travis are going on another huge adventure together in life, and I am very happy to say that I trust Travis to take care of Danielle 100%. May your relationship thrive with Christ and in each other. To Mr. and Mrs. Alski.
So thank you, Danielle, for sharing his passion for being a nerd, but for also being a normal human that knows how to socialize. And thank you all again so much. Cheers to these beautiful, these beautiful freaks. Cheers.
Come on now.